Hi guys, my name is Harvansh and thanks for watching my other videos about the SCCM tutorial where you was learn how we can install the SQL database, the primary site and the other roles. And today this video is I am making about how we can install the secondary site. So before installing the secondary site, we need some prerequisite and you know guys, it's very tough to remember what needs to be done on the secondary sites, like which roles, .NET and all. So for this solution, I have a tool that is developed by some other guy. So I will paste this link and easily you can get it from the TechNet. Okay, so this is the tool. When you are installing any the primary site or the secondary site or the cache server, you select it and install it. So already I run this tool and if you want to show, I can show you here. Okay, so you just select this secondary site and click on install. So it will install all the prerequisites. There are the 18 prerequisites required to install the secondary site. So add it showing like no change needed. That means it's already I run this tool and already prerequisite was installed. Okay, so after run this tool on the your secondary server, you go to the primary site and SCCM site, go to the administrator. After the administrator, go to the site configuration. Here is a site, you select this option and here you can see in it a create a secondary site. Just click on that create a secondary site, click on next and here you can give like the site code SS1 I am giving. So you can give the 3-digit code for your site and it can be a numeric and the alphabetic as well. Here you have to give the server name, secondary site server name. So what I have, we can browse that. It is SCCM-SS. Okay, so name got resolved. Now this is, and the site name. This is my the Bangalore secondary site. Okay. My the installation path will be in C drive because I have only the one drive, C drive. If you are having the D drive or E drive, if you want to change the path, you can change it from here. Now click on next. Copy installation source file. Okay, I am copying my the source file from the primary site. So click on next. Here is a port. So no need to change the port. This is the SQL port and this is the server service broker point. Click on next. It's like a distribution point. Install the configure if it is required by the configuration DP. Okay, no need to do any changes because already I done the prerequisite there by running the tool which I show you earlier. Click on next. This option is a primary content library location. So automatically I set by default it's automatically by default it will be taken any sites. And if you want to install your the content library in a D drive or E drive, you can select it. I don't have the D and E drive, so I will keep it like a automatic only. The primary package here location. So where you will keep your the package folder in D drive or E drive, you can give the path here. Like select the D drive or E drive, F drive, anything. So your package folder will be creating there. Click on next. And it's like a validated the content. No, I don't want to set up it. If you want to set up, you can select this and schedule it to validate your content. Here is a boundary group. So still I have not created any boundary group there. That's why it's not showing. And I will show you in the coming video how we can create a boundary and the boundary group. So as of now, we can leave as it is. Okay, so these are the settings what we were selected during running this console. Okay, if anything is missed out, you can validate, or if all are fine, you can click next. If you feel like something goes wrong or you have selected wrongly, you can click on the previously and correct it. So click on next. And here is a, this is showing there is a no error, but setup is not started yet. Here we can see in it the secondary site, add, it's a Bangalore secondary site, type of secondary site, site code SS1, and here you can click on refresh and right click and see the installation logs. So here it's showing begin prerequisite checks. So now it's checking the prerequisites, whether if it is a missing anything, it will throw an error, or if it is all good, installation will be starting. Click on refresh and we can check if there is any error comes, we'll troubleshoot it here right now. Okay guys, so some logs came, new logs. This is after this begin prerequisite check is okay. Verify the FQDN server management, check the server services is fine. So looks like everything is fine here. Okay, as I told you, if there is any issue come or error come, we will check and we will troubleshoot. Let me refresh it again where it reach. Okay, so verify that IIS is running. Okay, fine. So looks like all the prerequisites goes past. Okay, there is some warning. Warning is like the site server unable to publish the Active Directory. Okay, this we will check it later. And we can see how much it got progressed. Okay, so prerequisite check complete. Installation will fail if there is any prerequisite not passed. Like as of now it passed warning, and if it is like a critical or any error. So prerequisite check, now we can go here and can see if there is any some folders created. No. Okay, still folders has not created. I think it's under progress. We have to wait few minutes. Once this setup will copy and it will start installation. Guys, we have to wait some time. And let me refresh again. Okay, still it's not moved. I think it's copying the setup file. Let me refresh it. Okay, it is stuck there. We'll wait for some time. Okay, we have to wait for some more times. Once the setup will copy there and setup will started. Let me refresh again. Okay, still checking. let me refresh here. It's saying still it's pending. We have to check logs. Refresh and click on show logs. We have to wait still few more times. Okay, let me refresh it again. Okay. So begin downloading and verifying installation file. So let's move one step. Installation of the secondary site. Now maybe the file will be creating here. Okay, so new file is created to install the SQL. Okay guys, so it will start installation. Now there is no error, no problem. I'm pausing this video for some time. So once it will install or is there any problem, I will resume it again. Let me refresh it again. Okay, we'll go on the secondary site and here I will show you the logs. So these are the logs created for the my secondary site under the C drive. Here is some error for the registry key. What is that? So name instance for the SQL registry key. That's fine. And here is a setup is started. So the SQL server express installation command is this. So now it installing SQL express server here. Okay, so under the program data Microsoft. Program file MySQL server. Okay, so MySQL server is getting installed. After this SQL installation, my SCCM secondary site setup will start. So here we can check. Okay, SQL new folder created and looks like it almost done. So 400 MB downloaded. Maybe it will take some more time. You can see here also log. Okay, downloading begin, installation verifying the installing file. Okay guys, the logs got changed and it's showing now evaluating the secondary site server installation success. Begin the creation of the secondary site database. Okay, it's creating a database for the secondary site and we can check the logs here. Okay, it's keep on it's running. So the setup is getting installed. Now it's showing like a configuration manager. This is started. Bin file also came. And it will take some more time to installation completed. So it's creating a file, moving the files on in folder. Let it continue some more time. Looks like almost completed. Let me go here, refresh it again. Okay, it's under the begin. We'll see this logs. How much is done? Okay, reading the primary site BLR SQL connection success rate and SMS success. Now this part is done. Okay, it's like completed. So completed configuration manager server startup. From here it looks like everything fine and the site code SS1 is completed. And guys, like luckily it's completed without any error. Now we can see in it here whether the everything is fine or not. Still it's showing under the progress. So this status also it will updated. Let me click OK. Click on refresh, and it's still it is showing pending. Let me go again back and check this status. It will update. You can check verify again the logs whether the everything fine or not. The logs we have to check is configuration startup log. And finally it looks like everything done here. Okay, and what about the wizard log, the source existing WPF exes? Okay, we have to go again the site, secondary site installation, and we have to wait some more time when the status message will update it here. Okay, so now it's showing the active. Okay guys, so now my secondary site is completed without any issue, and in this video you have learned how we can install our secondary site under the primary. So primary site, secondary site is installed and it's showing now active, and it is a site code is SS1 secondary site 1, and is the parent site code is a BLR. So my secondary site reporting to the primary site, that site code is BLR. Okay guys, thank you for watching this video, and please subscribe my channel and press bell icon to get the notification. I will be creating some more videos about the SCCM. Now we are on the installation part. So I want to show you how we can install and install the DP secondary site and the primary sites. So later on I will explain you about the asset and compliance, security library, monitoring, reporting, dashboards and others. Okay guys, so thanks for watching this video, and please subscribe my channel. Thank you.